Reliance Commercial Finance presents India SME Forum 2012. Find out the secrets of success in a series of seminars exclusively for smart entrepreneurs. Join India's biggest SME initiative to boost your business and celebrate SME achievers with India SME 100 Award.
Good afternoon to all. While I get my presentation up, I think I'll address a few of these things that got discussed today, especially on security, cloud, safety, things like that. See, there are two parts to the exercise of building a brand. Okay, well, you can build a brand, but then maintaining it, building credibility into it, keeping it going for a long time has got its own challenges. From that perspective, what we are planning to offer or what we would like to help is in that space where we help you build systems, put processes in place so that it's easier to make sure your credibility, your reliability, your in-time response, etc., etc., is possible. I will not talk specifically about TCS much. I will do address some of my products in the meantime. Other part that I wanted to say is the security part. See, data security is the biggest concern, but it has changed or evolved as time goes. And as Shashi mentioned, most of the bank has data on the cloud. Otherwise, we won't be able to go to ATMs and swipe it. We have to be very careful whenever we are using cloud to find out what kind of infrastructure is the service provider having. I will highlight that a little bit while we go through this presentation. Cloud computing, I hope I'm clear. I just pushed it down so I can see the slides. Okay. See, cloud computing basically is a scalable, elastic IT adoption methodology. Yeah? In simple words, that's what it's all about. What is critical about it? Connectivity. How come it became possible? Internet. Internet became very wide, possible, and hence cloud can be adopted very well. It's service-based. It is elastic and scalable. It's shared. Okay. It is metered by use, and it's internet-based. There are good things and bad things about it. I've got a small slide about it at the end, so maybe we can discuss it later after that. Again, in cloud, you have to remember one thing. Interfaces are defined. There is not much scope for flexibility in changing what interfaces you have. You have scales to add resources or remove resources as needed. Resources are pooled. Yeah, like a data center is pooled by all the users so that the cost comes down. The other way to look at it is since the costs come down, you can afford to have better quality. Yeah, and then usages are tracked. Data is not tracked, usage is tracked. And it is delivered over internet protocols. So there are certain applications needed by certain industries which may not be possible to be delivered on the internet, so then you should not be looking at cloud. There are three kinds of cloud. Gentlemen, this is where security becomes crucial, so I think you would all have to take some time to understand this. There is infrastructure as a cloud. This is very simple. Instead of having a computer in your office or wherever it is, you move it to a data center. Whatever you put on it, you can access it. Typical example is a website. Yeah, all of us would have websites, so if we have put it up there, it's on a server, it's accessible by anybody, everybody who has IP address or the URL for it. The second is platform as a cloud. In platform, a lot of other applications are also given. For example, database, right? Everybody needs a database to run a software. So database servers are provided, app servers are provided, so you don't have to buy the licenses for those. But you still have to build a software which you can host on it. And the third that is, there is software as a service. In this case, even everything that you need to use at the server side, you will still need endpoint terminals or computers to access it. It can be a tablet, it can be a computer, it can be a smartphone. But the server side of it is completely taken up, put it in a place. The application that is needed, be it a ERP, be it a DMS, be it a CRM, be it accounting, whatever, is hosted and shared by everybody No licenses are being sold. You are being charged for using it. This is the three kinds of clouds available. Now, when you are on the first or the second, you have control over your database, your data, etc. When you move on to the SaaS mode, it is very crucial you select the right kind of supplier or vendor. For example, in TCS, what we do is a class one data center. Class one data center is what banks use. Yeah, it has got a 15-level security mechanism in place. There is a list of conditions that is defined by the government to use or to be met to be classified as Cat 1. And then there is a disaster recovery or business process continuity put in place. What that means is if this server goes down, I should have another server to take up. This complete data center goes down, there should be another data center to take up. There should be established processes for managing data, cleaning it up, archiving it, pulling it back, et cetera, et cetera. So if you are moving on cloud and you are going to use SaaS, please have to be very, very, very careful about the service provider you select. I will now give you a brief idea about what TCS puts up. I think that's slide, yeah. TCS offers end-to-end IT services, which means I offer the software as well as the hardware, and in case needed, even the network connectivity needed to link up the whole thing. Yeah, so I can provide you with desktops, laptops, printers, in case needed, on-premise servers, which is needed in some solutions, and all system software, connectivity, network devices, hosting, etc. We provide document management, online presence management, enterprise management, messaging and office management. These we call the common office applications that is needed, which can be used by any industry in any format. Then we come to the common business applications. We have the CRM, the finance and accounting, procurement and entry, HRMS, payroll, and projects. We have manufacturing, textile, education, retail, and wellness as specified verticals we can cater to. And on top of it, we provide business analytics. All of these are available on a monthly payment mode, even the hardware. Yeah, so we can actually ensure that no customer has to have a capital investment to be made in case they want to adopt IT technology. I'll just go back to one slide, just to show the pros and cons. What are the biggest pros for cloud? It is pay as you go, use, build as you grow. You can increase when your organization grows. For the same reason, if you come down, you can reduce the usage also. It needs very low IT execution ability. This was covered by Shashi also. Biggest challenge that SMEs face is to have the experts who can build the solution and maintain it for you. So this takes out that particular risk from the whole thing. Deployment is faster. Normal ERP deployments can take anywhere between 6 months to 2 years, 3 years. We have been able to achieve deployments in less than 90 days. Accountability. Having a trusted partner, you can rest assured there is accountability for the whole business practices that we are building in it, and the global reach. As a customer, as well as a vendor, both of us can achieve global reach by using cloud. Biggest challenge is data privacy, confidentiality, and security. The only way to address that is to ensure that you have tie up with the right service providers, which are hosting this on a private cloud. It should never be a public cloud. Yeah? How long is data retained? We retain it forever. Other service providers may not retain it forever. They will say, we will give you 3 years, 5 years of data. Afterwards, you have to take it off. And then what are the termination and usable data clauses? There are many guys who will say, once you sign up, you have to be there with us for 5 years so that you are stuck with him for 5 years. And many people basically will say, this part of your data is usable by the service provider. I will have a look at your customer details, blah, blah, blah. So please read the fine print that says which part of the data are they going to access, which part of the data they will give you in writing that they will not access. Integration with on-premise systems is very difficult on cloud. And customizing applications beyond a point is very tough on cloud. I will stop there.